We would now want to invite Honorable Steve Twigg, the Secretary General of the CPA, for his remarks. Honorable Twiggs has been a committed, very dedicated leader of the CPA. He's very hands-on, and he has been here since the inception of the organization of this program. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, and good morning, everyone. Your Excellency, Nana Akufo-Addo, the President of the Republic of Ghana, the Right Honourable Speaker of the Parliament of Ghana, the Honourable Alban Bagbin, ladies and gentlemen, if I may say, all protocols observed. It is a great pleasure to be here today for this opening ceremony for the 66th Commonwealth Parliamentary Conference here in Accra, Ghana. And I'm especially pleased to follow the Majority Leader, Honourable Bonsu, who has served with great distinction as the Vice Chairperson of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association since 2021. And if I may say, on all our behalves, a big thank you to the Honourable Bonsu for his service. May I also express gratitude, I'm sure, on behalf of all of us here today, to the Parliament of Ghana for hosting this 66th CPC. It is a significant responsibility for any branch to take on to host a Commonwealth Parliamentary Conference, and the team here in Ghana has delivered with professionalism, with commitment, and with delegation and with dedication. Can I thank you, Mr. Speaker, and the team here in Ghana for hosting us here in Accra this week. Our theme for this 66th CPC is the Commonwealth Charter 10 years on. And in everything that we in the CPA seek to do, we seek to embody and implement the values set out in that Commonwealth Charter. And I'm pleased to have the opportunity this morning to give some examples of this. Our recommended benchmarks for democratic legislatures have proved a very powerful tool in assisting you, assisting the parliaments of the Commonwealth to improve practice and share the very best about democracy and good governance. 2 years ago, we launched our online CPA Parliamentary Academy, and almost 1,500 have signed up to courses, both parliamentarians and parliamentary staff. And last week, I was very pleased to represent the CPA in New York at the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals Summit, where we launched our new academy course on the crucial role of parliaments and parliamentarians in the implementation of the United Nations Agenda 2030 towards the Sustainable Development Goals. And of course, one of those goals, SDG 4, is about access to quality education for all. I was very pleased on Monday evening that we held the inaugural Emilia Monjowa Lifaka Lecture here in Accra with Betty Abeng, the Chief Executive of the Commonwealth Education Trust. In this year of youth, the Commonwealth Year of Youth, this provided a timely opportunity both to remember our late chairperson, Madam Lifaka, and at the same time to rededicate ourselves to the importance of education in all parts of the Commonwealth. Let me say a word about our three networks. The CPA's commitment to women's representation and gender equality lies at the very heart of our mission. And last year, when we met in Halifax, Canada, a very important set of constitutional reforms was agreed, including that a minimum of one-third of delegates to future CPCs should be women, and similarly a minimum of one third of the places on our executive committee. And I pay tribute to CWP for the leadership that they've shown in this organisation in getting us to this point, which means that this week 40% of the voting delegates here will be women. And this reflects progress in many parts of the Commonwealth. Let me congratulate Sierra Leone on their reform, which has resulted in a doubling of the number of women in their recent election. Let us congratulate New Zealand on achieving 50% women over this past year, and pay tribute to our colleagues in India, whose parliament has recently passed a landmark reform, the aim of which is to secure at least one third women in future across India. Progress is happening, but there is still a lot more that needs to happen. And we know that human rights lies at the heart of the Commonwealth Charter. And that means addressing the rights of minorities in our communities. And that's why I'm so proud that last year we adopted into our constitution for the first time the work of our Commonwealth Parliamentarians with Disabilities Network. This network is going from strength to strength. I'm so pleased at the difference that it's making. For example, the Capital Investment Fund to support member parliaments to be as accessible and inclusive for persons with disabilities as possible. And earlier this week, we had a wonderful visit with the CPWD regional champions to the Accra Rehabilitation Centre, looking at the work by organisations for persons with disabilities here in Ghana. And then, of course, we have our small branches network. Last year, we agreed to expand that network to any jurisdiction where the population is up to 1 million. The small branches network really leads the way in this organisation on a lot of issues, especially on climate change because of the role of the small island states in that network, on the environment and biodiversity more generally, and on disaster risk management. And those three networks will all have their chance to report to the General Assembly in this hall tomorrow. We have a busy agenda tomorrow for the General Assembly. And one of those, and this is the final matter I'll comment upon this morning, is the one that Honourable Bonsu referred to. The long-standing question of the CPA's legal status. An issue that I know has been on the agenda for 3 decades, and which I am determined, as Secretary General, that we finally now resolve. That is why there is a set of proposals tomorrow to take us forward as an organisation so that we cease to be a charity and we become an international, interparliamentary organisation properly reflecting the role and function of the CPA. I will speak more about this tomorrow, but simply to say that I am now more hopeful than I have ever been that we are finally going to secure the legislation in the United Kingdom for which we have been campaigning for so many years. But we're equally clear to the government of the United Kingdom that if that doesn't come in the next 6 months, the process for a possible relocation outside of the United Kingdom will proceed. No doubt about that. No question about that. That will be the message that we will be sending to our friends in the government of the United Kingdom. So finally, let me take this opportunity to thank all of you for being here. Can I also express my gratitude to my colleagues in the CPA Secretariat staff for their hard work both this week at the conference and week in, week out throughout the year. Please can we have a big round of applause for the staff of the CPA Secretariat. I wish everyone a successful conference, an impactful conference, and I hope an enjoyable conference. The wonderful hospitality that we've already received from our Ghanaian hosts is something very, very special. and I thank them for it. Thank you, everyone. Have a good conference.
Thank you very much, Secretary General of the CPA, Honorable Stephen Tweed.